So in this video, we're back out on the site from the marking up video. And what I'm going to show you this time is how we go about taking our setting out and then creating formwork for a slab on ground. This is a slab on ground. As you can see, the main feature of this slab is that it has a step or a rebate. So what happens when we construct the house? Our brick veneer goes on the lower edge of this step, and our timber frame sits up on the top of this step. So that allows us to put our flashing in and form weep holes in our brickwork so we can drain any moisture or any water that gets behind our brickwork can come out and not make any contact with our timber frame. So that's what we need to achieve. So remember from the marking up video, we got all our string lines in place. Looks something like that, and now we can start to create our formwork. So the first thing we need to do, pick a side, any side, and plumb down your main points. In fact, what I would do is I would go around the whole site and I would transfer these marks down onto the ground with some spray paint or a bit of lime or scratch a mark on the ground, whatever you've got available. But plumb or use a spirit level or a plumb line and transfer these marks onto the ground. Then we can go around and actually lay our timber boards in place, or our edge boards. Now, because this is formwork, we don't want to necessarily cut these timbers to exact lengths. So where possible, we want to actually extend these past our points. This one is actually cut tight or cut in between. But you'll see a lot of the other ones in the video will be extended past. So where you can, don't cut formwork to length because you want to be able to reuse it. Okay, I'll get rid of the string lines here shortly. So what we have to do is we put these pegs in to hold our edge board in place. This is one method of supporting the edge boards. I'll show you another one shortly. The disadvantage of this method is that when you drive these pegs in, if they hit a rock in the ground, or you've got particularly hard ground, it's very hard to keep that edge board exactly where you want it to be. So there is a way of getting around that. I'll show you in a second. So first thing we have to do, support our edge boards at both ends, and then we need to get it straight. So the best way to do that, grab a block of timber. We actually need three, all the same thickness. One block goes on this end. Another block goes down on the other end. We take a string line and we wrap it around the blocks. So a nail here, take it around the block up to the other end. Once again, a nail, tie it off tight. And then we can put a block in the center. And if the block slips between the edge board and the string line, without any gap, then the edge board is straight, so we can put a peg behind that. And we just repeat that process as many times as we need to get our pegs in. Now, depending on the edge of this, the thickness of this edge board, you're probably going to want a support roughly every meter behind your edge board. It depends on how thick it is. Whether it's going to bow or not under the weight of the concrete, so that's a decision you'll have to make yourself, but roughly every meter you'll need a support. Okay, so there's our first edge board in. Now, we're going to swing around and do our next one. So, as I said before, you can either put your string lines back up, which is a bit of a pain, or you can already have this mark transferred down, put in another edge board. Now, in this case, one edge board wasn't going to be long enough, so we had to join it with a cleat. And the process is the same, except this time to support the edge board, I'm going to use two pegs and a ledger. So this just means I can drive these pegs in anywhere, pretty much. They don't have to touch the edge board, and then I can slide this ledger in till it touches the back of the edge board. Now the only thing you need to be careful of is that this ledger is level. So at the moment, that looks like you're using a lot more timber than what you used during using this method, which you are, but you'll see when we actually form the rebate, it'll become a little bit more efficient. So one support at that end, support at the other end, string line the face again with our blocks, and we straighten out the formwork. Put a support in the middle. Keep checking it with your block and put all your supports in. So that's the process, and you just have to work your way around the entire site until you get that done. So that's the first layer, or the bottom step of our rebate. So now we need to do the top step. So what we're going to use is another peg and a ledger. And that peg and ledger, well, the peg's just going to be back whatever length your ledgers are. And we need to sit this top of this ledger 150 mil in. So if you measure 150 mil from the back of this edge board to the face of your ledger, that will mean that it will be 150 mil from the face of this edge board to the face of the edge board we're going to put on here. And we just do that all the way along. So that's one method. There are brackets that you can purchase or you could have made that just simply sits over your bottom edge board, and then you screw them on to the bottom of the edge board, the bottom side. You then sit your second edge board on here, and they screw into the back of that. So that does the same job a little bit quicker than using the timber edge boards. But if you're going to if you're not going to do it very often, then you may not want to go the expense of purchasing these brackets. So we'll go back to the timber method. So that's that edge done. You can see on the other side where we use the different method. Now we've already had that second peg in place, so we just had to put the ledger in, make sure it's overhanging the 150 mil, and that's complete. So realistically, with this system, the only extra timber we're using is that bottom ledger over this system. So it's a little bit more efficient than it used to look. I personally think this is a better way of getting nice straight edge boards using this method. Can't get your edge boards as straight. And again, we have to go around the entire site and do that. And then once that's done, we go around and put in our top edge board. And we've got our rebate formed. Go and have a little bit of look around. Nowhere. Come back. Okay, so once we've got our edge boards in and all our formwork's done, we then have to think about filling up the center of the field of the slab. So one of the methods that's quite commonly used nowadays is a styrofoam pod. In Australia, they call them waffle pods. Because this, the inside of your house is not going to get heavy traffic, just furniture and people. You really don't need to have a slab that's 200-300 mil thick. So what they do is they put these pods in, and that just means that for the majority of the slab, the thickness of the concrete's only about 100 mil, which is heaps. If you're going to have an area in your house that was going to take heavy loads, like possibly a garage or somewhere we're going to have a pool table or a spa or a waterbed that might have point loads on your floor, you would have to consider that in your design and possibly remove the waffle pods in those areas, but that's up to your structural engineer to work out. So the waffle pods go in. Now, instead of using waffle pods, you could use dirt or, sorry, controlled fill and sand, but nowadays waffle pods are the common thing. Once your waffle pods are in, you place some trench mesh in the lower half to reinforce the bottom of these beams that will be formed by the waffle pods. And then on top of that, on the top of the waffle pods, you put in your fabric reinforcement or the mesh, and that gives you all the reinforcement for your slab. And of course, once that's all done and it's been inspected, you pour the concrete. So you can see now our little step here has been formed in the slab. And there's our slab formed. Now, once you've poured the slab, it generally should take about 7 days before you pull this formwork off. A lot of contractors and professional concreters will do it on the same day, but the risk is that if someone or something was to run along one of these edges, then the concrete could possibly fall off. So you really want to leave it 7 days. It takes 7 days to get some strength about it, and then realistically, it takes 28 days to reach its designed strength. So there we go. There is our slab on ground with our rebate all formed up, ready for our frames and our bricklayer.